To the beat of Timorese drums, these survivors remember the school friends they lost 30 years ago during a massacre in Timor-Leste's capital.
I think three of my friends didn't come back till now.
We waiting to pray. After pray, we wanna put the flower in the cemetery. Even we didn't pray yet, the Indonesian army come and just shooting us like this. They shooting us like animal, you know.
Maria Jose and Osvaldo Colio now live in Darwin, but in 1991 they were among the students fired upon by Indonesian soldiers while peacefully protesting for independence at the Santa Cruz Cemetery in Dili.
When I heard the shots, I started to panic. I don't know where I'm going to do.
After running for their lives, they were then forced to hide.
Afterwards, the Indonesian soldier came searching for this demonstrator hiding in that place.
A ceremony in Darwin has honoured the students who died and survived, and the man who exposed the massacre to the world, filmmaker Max Stahl, who recently passed away.
Lucky that days, Max Stahl, journalist Max Stahl, is there with his friend and make a lot of progress for our freedom.
As one of our big brother, we thank to him.
November 12 is now a national holiday in Timor-Leste, and the names of those who died have been woven into the memories of this community. Felicity James, ABC News.